Hey guys, just quickly before I jump into this video, if you'd like to talk to me or other scam baiters, feel free to join the Aurora Discord. The link will be in the description, and hope you enjoy the video. Thanks for watching.
We are calling you from the technical headquarters of Windows, as you are using a genuine version of Windows product. And as we are the Windows technical department, we received some report regarding your computer issue. And that is the reason, sir, we are calling you, okay?
Alright. C as in Charlie.
M as in mother.
M as in mother.
D as in doctor.
D as in doctor. I've got CMD.
Yeah. On the bottom, can you see okay?
Yeah, I see okay.
Give a click on okay.
Alright. And this black window's come up. It says C users Andy.
Yeah. Yeah. And if you look on the right, on the bottom, can you see right next to your username? There is a cursor flashing over there.
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah, over there simply type A as in alpha.
A as in alpha.
S as in sugar.
S as in sugar.
S as in sugar once again.
Yep.
O as in Oscar.
O as in Oscar.
And C as in Charlie.
Okay, I got S O C. I've got A double S O C.
That's right. After that, press enter from your keyboard.
Okay. Oh, there's a lot of things that have come up now.
Okay. And if you look from the bottom, sir, from the bottom third, can you see there's a very longest line over there from the bottom third?
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah, which says CL, like it says ZF send to target. Equals to CLSID. Can you see that line?
Yes, I see that.
Yeah. So do you have any idea, sir, what CLSID actually stands for?
I have no idea.
Okay, let me tell you, sir. CLSID stands for Computer License Security ID. Like, CLSID is a license ID of your computer, which are providing your computer from the Microsoft Corporation since you purchased the computer. And as we are the Windows Technical Department, as we are the authorized service provider of all the Windows computers, we have your computer license ID, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So for the verification purpose, sir, what I will do, I will just read out the license ID from my side, and you need to check it from your side whether the license ID is matched or not, okay?
Alright.
So your computer license ID is 88-8-DCA-60-FC-0A-number-11-CF-00F-0000-4SD-7D-062. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's all right.
Yeah, so the verification process is completed, sir. And let me tell you, sir, that this is the same medium through which your computer receives Windows update, as well as this is the same medium through which we receive notifications from your computer, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and in the future as well, sir, if you receive any calls about your computer or else about your computer problem, please verify the license ID before proceeding any calls further, okay?
Alright.
Yeah, so I will just show you the problem as I have told you before, sir. Look on the black box on the bottom. Can you see right next to the user there's a cursor flashing over there once again?
Yeah, I see that again.
Over there, simply type E as in Edward.
E as in Edward.
V as in Victor.
V as in Victor.
E as in Edward.
E as in Edward.
N as in Nancy.
N as in Nancy.
T as in Tiger.
T as in Tiger.
V as in Victoria.
V as in Victoria.
W as in Whiskey.
Yeah, I got that.
And R as in Romeo.
R as in Romeo. Okay.
Yeah. So confirm me the word.
Event viewer.
Yeah. Give a press enter from your keyboard.
Alright, I've done that. It's loading. It's very slow. Alright, it's loaded.
Okay. What do you can see exactly?
It's just loading. It says reading data, please wait. It's taking a while. This computer's really slow. Wow. It's really slow.
Okay.
Well, I'm
As you have
seeing.
mentioned, you said your computer running from a very bad condition. That's why it will take some time.
Yeah, it's really slow now. Holy crap. Oh, it's freezing on me now. All right, I guess I'll just wait for it to load. Okay, it's loaded now.
Okay, what you can see exactly?
There's some warnings and errors and information I see.
You can see warning error information on the page,
Yeah,
right?
I can see loads of warnings and errors.
Like, what you can see exactly, let me know, apart from that error and warning.
Just some like exclamation marks and red errors, that's all I can see really.
Okay. As you can see, sir, I'm showing you the errors and warnings because they are quite in a large number in your computer. They are the infections which are present in your computer. So what we need to do right now, we need to connect your computer to our Windows headquarters so that we can show you the problems easily, okay?
All right.
Yeah. Press the Windows key along with the alphabet R.
Okay. I've got the Rundy box again.
Okay. Over there is in type. Over there is in type or is it empty?
Yeah, it's empty.
Sound activated.
www.
www.
Put a dot.
Okay, put a dot.
Number 121.
121.
Type the whole word support.
Support.
Put a dot.
Dot.
Type online. Online. Online.
Online.
Then
Okay, I've
show me
got
the
that.
word.
It's just, I don't know what's going on. It's loading, I think. Okay, yeah, it's loading. I see Internet Explorer's up.
What you can see exactly?
Get your technician live now. Connect on Windows.
And look on the top. Can you see TeamViewer Supremo?
TeamViewer. Yeah, I see TeamViewer,
And right next to TeamViewer, can you see Supremo?
yeah, I see that.
Give up, click on Supremo.
Okay, one second, I'm clicking on it.
After you give a click on Supremo, what come next?
It's just loading. Just give it a second. Okay, it says supremo.exe, run or save.
Give a click on Run.
Okay, I'll run it. It's loading.
After you give a click on Run, if you receive any new option, let me know.
Okay, run. Okay, I've just clicked run again.
After you give a click on Run, if you receive any option, let me know.
Okay, it says, do you want to allow the following program to make changes? All right, yes.
Give a click on Yes. After you give a click
Okay.
on Yes, look on the bottom right. You will see Accept option. Give a click on Accept.
Okay,
I
so I've
will click on
got, oh
Accept.
yeah, I see here, run Supremo, accept. And there we go,
Okay,
it's loaded. It
Accept.
says ID and
Give a click on
password.
Accept. Read out the ID slowly, slowly.
Okay, it is 609
Okay.
018 696
Okay. Confirm with the password.
1943.
Okay. Sorry? Confirm the password once again.
It is 1943.
1953.
No, 4-3.
4-3.
Yes.
Give me a second. Congrats, now you are successfully connected. As
All
you can
right.
see, I am the moving mouse cursor on your screen.
That's good. Okay, so what we're going to do?
Okay, I will help you out to check the problem easily, okay?
All right.
Sir, as I can see, the computer is very slow.
Yeah, it is.
So how old is this computer, you say?
It's not that old, and I don't really use it that much.
Okay, it is not too much old, right?
Yeah, and I don't use it that much. I only use it a little bit. I don't go on the internet that much. I prefer to use my phone.
Okay, I understand. And sir, who mainly use the computer?
Just me, that's all.
Just you, right? Okay. So let me tell you, sir, as you can see, there are a fair number of events issuing 15, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So what I'm going to do, sir, in order to assist you in a better way, I'm going to transfer the call to one of our senior technicians out here so that they can guide you further in a better way, okay?
All right, thank you.
So give me a second, sir. I'm just going to transfer the call.
All right.
Thanks for being on hold, sir. This is Peter, and I'm the senior technician out here, and I will guide you further, okay?
All right.
All right. Now, I do believe my previous colleague showed you that error and warning, and I do believe he explained each and everything.
Yeah, he's explained each and everything for me about the warnings and everything.
All right. Now, let me tell you, sir, this error and warnings which are running inside of your computer. They are simply corrupting your mother operating system as well as your service part day by day, all right? And that's why, sir, the services which are providing you by Microsoft Corporation, they are getting stopped day by day. Let me show you that so that you have a clear idea, all right?
All right.
Anyone use this computer or you are the sole user, sir?
I am the only user.
All right, sir. And could you tell me, sir, how old this computer?
I don't know. I did get it recently. It's not that old, but I don't use it much. I think it's like a couple of months
All
old
right.
now.
All right. Now, can you see that, sir? We are in your system configuration part.
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah. Now, can you see that over there, various options, general boot services?
Yeah, I see that. Normal and all that.
You need to give a click on services from your end.
Okay, services.
Alright, now can you see that in the left-hand side, sir? These are the all services which are supposed to run in your computer, right?
Yeah.
And look at the middle, sir, the manufacturer. Most of them manufactured by Microsoft Corporation, right?
Yeah, I see that.
And look at the right-hand side, the status. Some of
They're
them running and
stopped.
some of them getting stopped day by day,
Oh, there's a
right?
lot of stopped ones. That doesn't look too good.
Yes. So do you have any idea, sir, why these essential services, which are supposed to run in your computer, but they are not running? They are getting stopped day by day. So do you have any idea why they are getting stopped day by day?
I don't know. Maybe I've got a virus or something.
I will explain you, sir. By those error and warnings which are running inside of your computer.
Oh, he hung up. He fucking hung up. See if they recall my home phone. Hello?
Yeah, sorry, sir, the line was disconnected.
Oh yeah, I was just typing on the computer there to you to
All
see
right.
if you could see it.
Yes, I can see that, sir. I
All
can
right.
see that. All right. Now, those arrow and warnings which are running inside of your computer. They are just simply corrupting your service part as well. And that's why, sir, all the services which are supposed to running in your computer, they are not running. They're getting stopped day by day. And after a certain time, your old services which are happening in your computer, they are getting stopped and may fix your computer crash down any point of time, alright?
Alright.
Alright, now can you see that? The most important service, which is called Application Identity, can you see that?
Yeah, I see that.
Which I'm highlighted in blue. Yeah. So Application Identity, which is your personal identity and your computer identity as well. And as you can see that, this service are getting stopped. So it means that your personal identification is compromised by unknown person whom you don't know, whom you don't trust, alright?
Mm-hmm.
And I do believe, sir, you send or receive email from this computer?
Yeah, I do sometimes.
Alright, actually, why I am asking you that question, sir, because when we are diagnosing the problem, we have also information that some error and warnings also coming from your email ID as well.
Yeah.
So we can't tell you verbally, we need to show you each and everything manually so that you have a clear idea, alright?
Alright.
Now what you need to do, sir, you need to simply put your email address over there, and after that you need to give a click on the check so that you can see whether your it's generating this kind of error warnings or not.
Oh, so you want me to put my email address in here? Okay.
Yeah. Now give a click on check.
Oh, that's a lot of errors.
Alright. Can you see that?
Yeah, I see.
Sorry, we found the following error 40.
Hmm.
And if you check that at the top, it's showing you 14 errors and 162 warnings. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Yeah. So actually this error and warning is also coming from your email ID as well. So it might be a chance, sir, your email ID is compromised by unknown person whom you don't know, whom you don't trust, alright?
Alright, so it's been hacked.
Yeah, so we need to secure your email ID as well. We need to put a 3D encryption in your email ID so that in future you can use your email ID securely and safely, alright?
Alright.
Alright, now let me show you why your email ID is generating this kind of error and warning so that you have a clear idea.
Alright.
Now, can you see that we are once again connected to our Windows Live server?
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah, and can you see a cursor is flashing over there beside your username?
Yeah, yeah, I can see that.
Simply type over there, N for Nancy.
N for Nancy. Oh. I need to click on it, there you go.
E for Echo.
E for Echo.
T for Tango.
T for Tango. Oh, what the hell? Net. Yep.
Then S for Sugar.
S for Sugar.
Then T for Tango.
T for Tango.
A for Alpha.
A for Alpha.
T for Tango.
T for Tango.
Now can you see her typing over there, netstat?
Netstat. Okay, I can see that.
Yeah. So, do you have any idea, sir, what is the netstat stand for?
I don't know. I assume it's something to do with the network. I don't know what it does.
Yeah, netstat means, sir, the statistic of your personal identification, sir. Now, to check the result, you need to press enter from your keyboard.
Oh, okay, I'll do that.
Now, here we go. Now, can you see active connection?
Yeah, I see a lot of connections here.
Yeah, active connection. Just below that, can you see local address?
Yeah, I see, yes. Yeah.
So, these are the all local IP address which is registered under your name. And look at the middle, sir. Can you see that foreign address?
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah, these are the all foreign IP address which are present in your computer. And if you check that in the right-hand side status, they're established in your computer. Can you see that?
Yes, I can see that.
Yeah, so these are the all foreign IP address which are present in your computer. And what they can do, sir, they can simply using your personal identification, like your personal data, personal documents, personal accounts like that. Just check that. those 49 IP addresses which are present in your computer, if they want, sir, they can simply check your account, they can simply check your computer, they can see your configuration, they can see your file, they can see your group. If they want, they can pause your computer. If they want, they can see your each and everything according to their benefit. If they want, they can stop your computer. And if they want, they can use your username as well. Alright?
Alright, that's a bit bad.
Yeah, so these are the foreign IP addresses which are present in your computer who are using your personal identification. And that's why, sir, your computer verification is on off right now. I will show you that.
Alright.
You see, I'm talking about their verifying?
Yes.
Yeah, now to check the result, you need to press enter from your keyboard.
Okay. Verify
okay,
is off.
Result is showing a verify is off. Can you see that?
Yeah, I see that. What does that mean?
Verify is off because foreign. Yeah. So, why it is showing you that verify is off? Because those foreign IP addresses which are present in your computer, they are using your name as those. That's why, sir, your computer verification is turned off. So what we need to do, sir, we need to remove those foreign IP address from your computer, and we need to put a 3D encryption in your IP address so that you can use your computer securely and safely in future.
All right.
Now I am going to check the last thing of your hardware part, sir. I'm simply open up a certificate of your hardware part. Oh my god, now can you see Microsoft Root Authority?
Yeah, I see that.
underneath of that, can you see Microsoft Windows hardware compatibility?
And I see this certificate has expired. Oh no. What does that mean?
This certificate has expired or it's not yet valid. Do you have any idea why this certificate it got expired?
I don't know. I don't know why it would have done that. What was happened?
I will explain you, sir. By those error and warning which are running inside of your computer, they're just simply corrupting your hardware part as well. And that's why, sir, your hardware certificate it got expired, alright?
Mm-hmm.
So what we need to do, sir, we need to reinstall this certificate once again. We need to renew the certificate once again. And after that, each and every problem are resolved on it, okay?
Alright, each and everything will be fixed, will it?
Yeah, we need to reinstall the certificate which got expired. Not only that, sir, we need to remove those error and warnings from your computer one by one. We need to restart the services which are getting stopped right now. We need to remove those foreign IP address from your computer, and we need to put a 3D encryption in your IP address and your email ID as well.
Alright.
You can use your internet connection and your email ID in future securely and safely. And apart from that, we need to restore this certificate which got expired right now. Alright?
Alright.
Alright, now to do that, sir, we will provide you a registration form in your computer. What you need to do, sir, you need to fill up the form from your end, and after that, a new license key generated under your name, and after that, each and every problem are resolved on it, okay?
Alright.
Now, let me tell you, to renew this certificate and to fix up all the issues, sir, there will be a one-time of nominal charge involved in it, okay?
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah, and there are multiple options for you, and you can choose any of them according to your convenience, sir, alright?
Mm-hmm.
And before I write down the charges, sir, I would like to provide you our contact details. Could you please be handy with a pen and a paper?
Yeah, I can do that. I got it right here. Yeah, I'm ready.
Alright. Mm-hmm. And when you have finished it, just let me know, sir.
Yeah, I'm just writing it down now. Okay, Peter Smith. All right, I've got all that down.
All right. Now I'm just simply write down the charges. All right.
All right.
And before I write down the charges, sir, for the verification purpose, sir, I do believe, sir, your age is above 21.
Yes.
All right. Actually, we don't have authorized to talk any person who is age under 21. That's why I'm asking you, sir. All right.
All right.
Now, can you see that there are 5 options for you?
Yeah, I see.
Yeah, and can you see that the top 3 plans with 3D protection? Can you see that?
Yeah.
Yeah, so 3D protection means, sir, suppose, sir, apart from this computer, if you have any multiple gadgets, like any phone, any tablet, any laptop, any computer, all the gadgets, it's called 3D protection, alright?
Mm-hmm.
And not only that, all the fan is transferable fan. Like, suppose in future, if you buy a new computer, or your family member buy a new computer, we will transfer this fan to your new computer or your new laptop as well, alright?
Alright.
Alright, now I'm simply write down the charging. These are the 5 options for you, and mm-hmm. you can choose any of them according to your convenience. And if you have any question, if you have any queries, you can definitely ask me, sir.
Alright.
And you need to reply over there which plan you want to move ahead, so that according to that, our technician will generate a form under your name, and after that, a new license key generated under your name, and after that, our technician will work in your computer, sir.
Alright. Okay, well, I think,
and you need to reply,
I think I'll go with the platinum plan for now.
Sorry?
I'll go with the second option, the platinum plan.
The platinum premium plan, right?
Yes.
Alright, and you need to reply over there which plan you want to move at, sir. Because according to that, sir, our technician will work in your computer.
Okay, I did that.
And you need to also write down the amount as well.
Sorry?
You need to write down the amount as well, sir.
Oh, right, yeah. Okay.
Alright. Now just hold on, shortly you will receive that plan, alright?
Alright.
Like form, you receive that form, alright? Now just hold on.
So, alright, we get into the payment page now.
Alright, now, can you see that form?
Yeah, I see that. You want me to fill that in for you?
Yeah, you need to fill up the form starting from your first name.
Okay, one second. Go. So it's Andy Wyrus. Company name, Thunder Tech Incorporated, address 14 Springfield, Mount, Leeds, LS2, 9ND. Okay, there you go, I've done that.
Alright, now just hold on,
Alright.
Now, you need to check each and everything, each and every information is correct?
Yeah, it's all correct, I've got it all correct here.
Alright, now just hold on. Now, shortly, sir, you will receive the form, and I would like to explain you one thing, sir. When you fill up the form, please do not whisper any of your valuable information over the phone, because each and every call has been recorded for online training and quality purpose.
Alright. So, what am I doing?
And what can you see right now?
Just the same page, it looks like it's loading or something.
And at the bottom right hand side, can you see that, like place order?
Yeah, I see that.
Click on place order.
Yeah, it's not doing anything, it's stuck on here I think. I think I have another browser, one second. I'll get a different browser because I'm pretty sure this is like a really old browser. Just give me a minute. Oh, not soft tonic. Ugh. No. Oh my god. Oh, it's right there. Okay, I'm just installing a new browser. It's going to fix each and everything. Hold on. Get rid of that. Skip it a sec. Here we go. Probably should have done this earlier, but I don't use this computer much, so I don't really bother.
Yeah, it's downloading. It's installing right now.
Yeah. There we go.
And Google Chrome is a good browser, sir, right?
I've got Opera. I prefer Opera. I don't like Google Chrome that much.
Alright.
But Opera is based on Chrome anyways. There we go. I think it's done now.
Close that page. Close that.
Yeah. Alright, here we are. Much better.
Alright. Oh, alright. Alright, now just hold on. Alright.
Still very slow, isn't it, this computer?
Yeah. Now just hold on, let me type that.
Alright.
Now, once again, just fill up the form, sir.
Yep, sure thing. Oh, it's already there. There we go. Now place the order.
Yeah. And when you receive the form, I would like to explain you one thing. Please do not whisper any of your valuable information over the phone, because each and every call has been recorded for online training and quality purpose. You need to fill up the form silently.
Alright. So 4-4-8-5-5-7 Oh, wait. And the CWE is 593 and the wireless pay now. Okay, I think that's went through. Oh.
It's processing through. Alright, can you see that? It's declined.
Shit.
And apart from this card, do you have any other card with you?
Yeah, I've got my masturbator card if you want me to get that.
Alright, we can use that.
Alright, 1 second. Okay. Oh, I'm tired. All right, I'm just oh. You've been active for too long, for God's sake.
Just hold on.
Yep, I'm holding on. You want me to hold on to my desk or my keyboard?
I will provide you the paste form, alright?
Alright.
Now use that MasterCard.
Yep, my masturbate card. 53 Oh yeah. Okay, and 10-17-786 Pay now. Oh, the hell! What happened?
Just hold on.
I think it crashed or something.
Have you pressed any key, sir?
Sorry?
Have you pressed any key from your keyboard?
No, I haven't done anything.
Alright, just hold on.
Alright.
Do anything, just hold on.
Alright, it's back up.
Can you see that? It's not gone through. And I do believe, sir, you have a sufficient fund on this card.
Yeah, I definitely have enough money.
Alright. And do you do any online banking?
Yeah, I have done before.
Alright, just hold on. Could you tell me, sir, which bank you are banking with, sir?
Halifax.
Halifax.
Yeah.
And I do believe you do online internet banking, right?
Yeah, I do.
All right.
I want me to log in. Yeah, it's not doing anything right now. I think it's frozen. Stupid goddamn computer. Oh, there we go.
First of all, use your username first.
Yeah, it's not letting me do anything though. It's just frozen. Alright, you can see I'm typing, but nothing's happening. I think someone's hacking my computer. I'm trying to, but it's not working. Still not letting me type anything. It's frozen again. I don't think this website's working. So what am I meant to do? It's not letting me type in here, it's just frozen. It's not doing anything.
Alright. Just hold on, sir.
Alright.
It's not doing anything.
Yeah, it's not loading. So what should we do? It's obviously not working. It's not even closing. Alright, there we go. I don't get what's wrong with it. Why is it not working? What's wrong with this goddamn desktop? Piece of crap. Fucking hate this computer. God damn it. Hey, you still there?
Yes, sir, I'm here.
Yeah, I don't know what's up with this goddamn computer, but it's pissing me off. Can we just fix this shit already? Say, it's not doing anything when you load on the website. It's a piece of shit, this website. Alright.
Now simply log into your account, so like how you
All right. Ugh. Internet Explorer. Still not working. Oh, there you go, it's crashed again. Oh, never mind, it's here. All right. I can't really see very well. Hold on. So it's Alright, I've entered my user details, is that right?
Alright, and click that each and everything.
Each and everything. Yeah, each and everything is right, I think. Could you just double check? I think is that right? I think it's meant to. Yeah, I think that's right. Yeah, continue. Oh, crap. Oh, shit. I think I might have forgot my password or something. Hello? Hello? Hello, I can't hear you. Hello? Hello, Madachad, are you there? Hello? Aww. Aww, no. They finally had enough, Devin. Holy crap.
That was fucking wonderful.
That was going on for way too long. You know, I bet they're going to fucking call back now. I bet they fucking call back.
So what, they called your home phone?
Yeah, oh my god, my home phone's about to die. Shit.
Oh no.
I've got to go put it on charge. Oh my god, that's amazing. Right, I got to fucking edit this shit, man. That was beautiful.
Yeah. No email from them.
Oh, wait, are you looking at my computer? Look,
wait, what?
The Siskiyou in it? The Siskiyou! The fucking Siskiyou in it? Oh, dude, that's beautiful. Wait, yeah. let me get the notepad. Fucking scammers. Terry. What? Oh no. Oh no. Chutia. Lundma. Salah. Benchard. Terry Ma. Was it Terry Mardy Puddy? No. Fuck you. Fuck you. Well, I'm just going to put Terry Mackey short. Oh my god, I need to get this translated.
Yeah.
Sal-E. Kuti. I'm not good with Hindi, sorry. Can you try and read this out? What the fuck is he writing?
Harem Court. I can't fucking pronounce this shit.
Jesus. Well, that was like a very slow scam bait, and it was getting quite boring, so I thought, you know what, screw it, let's just swear at him in Hindi and end this shit already.
Yeah.
Because like, I don't even know why the Halifax site wasn't working, but it was definitely fucking good that it wasn't working.
What the fuck is that ugly sidebar on Opera?
I have no idea. I don't have that on my Opera. He's trying to CSK again, I think. Oh, wait, no. CMD.
What's he doing now?
What's he doing?
Andy Warris.
Is he going to put fuck you or something?
Fuck you in the command prompt.
Sud. What the hell? I think he's trying to put Siski or something. But he's like misspelling it. Oh, no, wait. Is that his Hindi swear? Yeah, I'll do Siski for him.
Okay.
Update. There you go, I'll let him put the sys key in. See if he does it. Oh, no, he closed it. Oh, he didn't like that. Oh, no.
So that. See.
Is he trying to, like, sudo RMRF or something?
What the fuck? No.
No, no, here's how it's done. There you go. That's the correct command.
He's a fucking idiot. No, don't tell him! What are you doing?
Fuck. Fucking bastard. Oh, that's beautiful.
This guy is wonderful.
This guy is amazing. Ass. Hole.
Oh, you can't! If we get a scammer in a roar, that'll be the funniest thing ever.
I had a scammer in SSL once, and I think also my server.
Wow.
It was quite funny. And they were like, I was just talking to him. Oh yeah, I remember that live stream I did with the friendly scammer. He said he'd join my Discord, and yeah. And he probably is in there.
Oh, he's gone.
No, he terminated, no. Oh well, the system's... Ugh, I guess I'll pick up in. The system's probably broke now.
Yeah.
Oh well, that was a good...
That was a good meme.
End to the scam bait. Well, I should probably stop recording now.